In our last video, we explored how MCP can revolutionize file management. Today, we're diving under the hood. Whether you want to create your own MCP servers, integrate them with different AI clients, or master debugging tools, this video will give you everything you need to start building with MCP. We'll create a custom MCP server from scratch, explore the powerful MCP inspector, and learn essential debugging techniques that will save you hours of troubleshooting. Ready to expand the MCP ecosystem? Let's dive in! MCP supports a growing list of clients. Let's look at the list of applications that support MCP integrations here on the modalcontextprotocol.io/clients. We can see here that Cloud Desktop is included, and I have demonstrated how to use MCP with it in a previous video. We can also see several other clients here, but today we'll focus on Cline, an autonomous coding agent in VS Code that edits files, runs commands, uses a browser, and more with your permission at each step. The key features of MCP in Cline are create and add tools through natural language. For example, add a tool that searches the web. We will see this in action later. Share custom MCP servers Cline creates with others. Displays configured MCP servers along with their tools, resources, and any error logs. We'll start by adding the Brave Search MCP server to Cline to demonstrate these features. I have here my VS Code open. I already have installed Cline. You can install it by going to the extensions and searching for Cline. Once installed, Cline will ask for your LLM API key. You can use Anthropic, OpenRouter, or any API provider you choose. Cline works best with Sonnet. You can either use Anthropic or OpenRouter. Tip: OpenRouter allows unlimited use of Anthropic's API. So if you are using Anthropic as your API provider and hit the API limit, you can switch to OpenRouter to continue your work. I will use OpenRouter as my API provider and select the latest Sonnet model. You can also provide your custom instructions for the LLM here, then click Done. To see the available MCP servers in Cline, click the MCP servers button near the settings. We don't have any MCP servers now, so let's add the Brave Search. We have two options: manually add the MCP server or ask Cline to add it for us. To manually add an MCP server, we need to get the configuration for the MCP server from the official list in GitHub. Let's go to that GitHub repository in github.com/modalcontextprotocol/servers. Open the Brave Search MCP server and scroll down until you find the configuration. It says here that this is for Cloud Desktop, but it will also work with any MCP clients. We can see here that a Brave API key is required. To get an API key for Brave, simply sign up for a free account and add an API key. The free plan provides us with 2,000 free queries per month. Once you have your API key, copy the configuration for the Brave MCP server and head back to Cline in VS Code. Click the Edit MCP Settings button and paste the configuration. Make sure to paste your API key, then save the file. Cline will automatically reload the configuration and check for any errors. We can see that we've encountered an error. Now that we have Cline, an AI tool, at our disposal, we can ask Cline for a solution. Click Done to return to Cline's main UI and start a new task. Let's ask Cline to install the @modalcontextprotocol/server-brave-search-package locally via npm and use the dist folder under the node modules when adding the MCP server configuration for Brave. Once completed, go to the MCP server list again and see that the Brave Search MCP server is successfully installed. We can now start using it in our development. Click Done and start a new task. Let's say we want to check for the latest stable version of Next.js and use that. We can ask Cline to search if there's a higher version of the Next.js than what you know and tell me if there's a huge difference in its setup compared to what you know. When working with most AI tools, you might notice that they don't know the current date and time. Cline is also the same. If we ask Cline what date and time it is without using any command, it will tell us what it knows or say it does not know. One way to equip client to determine the current date and time is by allowing it to use an MCP server. So now, we will use client to build a simple MCP server that will tell the current date and time. Let's start a new task and ask client to do it in natural language. Let's see how it will work. Let's ask client, add a tool to tell the current date and time. Note that client will create a new folder in a particular folder on your computer, as we can see here. Client is now creating the files with auto approve option off, meaning we need to click yes so client can continue reading or writing files. Let's try to turn auto approve option on to let client work on autopilot without asking for permission. Now we can see that client is freely reading and creating files and executing commands without user intervention. By default, the max auto approve request is set to 20. We can reset that to let client loose again for another 20 times. Just like that, we were able to create our own MCP server with client's help. Now client can use this alongside other MCP servers. Let's try to ask for the latest version of Svelte relative to the current date. Let's ask client, get the current date first and then use it to search for the latest version of Svelte. Let's take this further by adding another server to fetch the latest documentation of any tech we want to use. We will use the Fetch MCP server from the official list this time. Let's head over to the server list and see how to install the Fetch MCP server. We can see that this is a Python server. Let's install it using UBX since it is simpler and more efficient. Let's copy the configuration and go to client's MCP server list. Click Edit MCP Settings and let's try to add this manually. Save client's MCP settings file, and we can see that client automatically adds it to the list after a few seconds. Now let's try to ask it to fetch the latest quick start docs for the Next.js version 15. Let's start a new task and ask client, get the current date first, and then search for the latest version of Next.js referencing the current date. Then fetch what's new, upgrading, and breaking changes guide. Save the result in a markdown file. Fantastic! We can now use this file as a reference for client when working with Next.js version 15. But what if we need to debug and troubleshoot our MCP server? MCP provides a debugging toolkit to help us troubleshoot issues effectively. On the debugging page, we can see the three main debugging tools. Here, we have the Claude Desktop Developer Tools, which provide integration testing, log collection, and Chrome DevTools integration. We also have server logging, which can help us implement custom logging, track errors, and monitor the performance of MCP integrations. We will not discuss these in detail, but feel free to explore this page to learn more. We will focus on the MCP inspector in this video. Let's demonstrate how to launch it using NPX, and let's inspect the Brave Search MCP server with the command npx at modal context protocol inspector npx at modal context protocol server Brave Search. After running that command, we see that the MCP inspector is up and running at localhost. Let's visit that in our browser. Since this particular server requires an environment variable, as we learned earlier, we must also provide it here. Click the Environment Variables button, scroll down to the bottom, and click the Add Environment Variable button. Let's check our MCP settings for the correct key and value. Let's go to Client, MCP Servers, and edit MCP settings. Then copy the key and value and paste it into the MCP inspector. Now click the connect button. We can see the status of the connection and the error output from the MCP server here. Right now, this is only an info log. If there's any error, we can always use client to debug. However, using the MCP inspector allows us to explore the capabilities of the MCP server more thoroughly. Let's explore the different areas of the MCP inspector. We can browse the available resources in the Resources tab and test subscriptions. Let's click on the list resources. We can see here there's an error, but this is not actually an error. It simply means that this particular server does not have resource listings or list templates. Let's check the prompts tab, where we can test prompt templates with custom arguments. This server does not have prompts either, and that's okay. Let's explore the tools tab to examine tools, schemas, and test execution. Clicking list tools shows two available tools on this Brave MCP server. Let's test the Brave web search tool. Upon clicking on the tool, we can see the parameters on the right and some information on how to use them. This is how the LLM knows how to use MCP tools. Now, let's input list of model context protocol servers in the query input box and click the Run Tool button. Almost instantly, we can see that the result is a success and the search results here. At the bottom, we can see the history of our actions. We can expand to see more details. We also see the notifications pane here to monitor server logs and notifications. In this case, we don't have any. We've covered a lot of ground today, from adding existing MCP servers to Clyne, developing our custom date and time server, and mastering debugging tools like MCP Inspector. With these skills, you're now equipped to use MCP and actively contribute to its ecosystem. Whether you're building tools for AI integration, creating specialized servers, or just wanting to understand how it all works under the hood, MCP's standardized approach makes it all possible. I have much more to share about MCP, building agents, and other AI-driven development techniques, so don't forget to subscribe, and thanks for watching. Happy coding!